Hello, hello, hello. I am the Linux Mitch. Are you still using Windows? Is your computer running slow? Is it sluggish? And do you think, man, I need to get a new computer? Or are you worried about Windows 10 coming to an end? Is your computer so old that you think you're not able to get Windows 11 installed on it? And you won't be able to upgrade to Windows 11? Have you been watching Linux videos and wondering if you should switch to Linux? And what are the advantages and disadvantages? Well, it all depends on what you do with your computer. Do you watch YouTube videos? Do you use it to go onto Facebook? Do you use it to surf the web? Do you use it to stream videos from the paid services that are out there? Do you use it to do your banking? Are you using it for work or for school? Do you use MS Word? Do you use Microsoft Excel? Do you do recording? What do you do with your computer? Now, the advantage is that switching to Linux, if you switch to Linux, your old computer is going to run a lot faster. It's going to be more secure, less chance of getting a virus, less chance of getting malware. Now, it doesn't mean a Linux computer can't get a virus or can't get malware, but it's way more secure and less chance of getting a virus or malware. Linux won't spy on you. You have a choice because there's probably at least 100 different types of Linux. So you have a choice of which Linux operating system you want to install on your system. And even when you choose a Linux distribution to install on your system, it's way more configurable than Windows. And you can change your desktop and make it look like the way you want it to look. You'll have access to Firefox and other web browsers, the Brave browser. If you want, you could install Google Chrome. I don't know why you'd want to do that. You have LibreOffice. It's a free open source Office suite. It has a Word document. It has a spreadsheet program. And it's compatible with Excel and MS Word. So, in other words, you'll be able to take your documents from MS Word and MS Excel and open them up and use them in LibreOffice. And it's free, it's open source. There's music players, there's video players, and all the programs that you download, you don't download them from the internet. You're going to download them from the App Store in the Linux distribution that you're using. Now, I probably shouldn't call it an App Store because all the apps are free. Everything is free. The operating system will be free, and all the apps that you download will be free, but they're coming from, for lack of a better word, an app store. Okay? Which means that all the apps that you download, they've been vetted by the maintainers of the Linux distribution that you're using. They've been vetted, so there's no virus or malware in them. Whereas with Windows, you just go on the internet and download programs from any old website, and there could be viruses or malware in them. And like I said, the Linux distributions, they don't, Linux doesn't watch what you're doing. They're not spying on you. They're not taking information from your computer or your web browsing and selling it to advertisers. So there's lots of reasons why you should go to Linux. Now, I switched from Linux over 4 years ago. And I have old computers, and when Windows 7 came to an end, I went to Windows 10. And my computers were running on Windows 10, but I just thought the Windows 10 was, I didn't really like it, and I thought it was really bulky and bloated. And I started watching some Linux videos, and I switched to Linux, and I haven't gone back. I'll never go back. Now you might say, well, you're in Windows right now. Well, actually, this is a virtual machine of Windows. Anyhow, I would encourage you to switch to Linux. And I'm going to do some more videos. I'm going to show you how to experiment and play with Linux. I'm going to show you how to install it. And I'm going to show you, well, I'm just going to show you the ropes. So this is not for advanced. This is for new people and people that are looking into Linux. So watch out for the coming videos. So I'm going to take you step by step and show you how to transition from Windows to Linux. And it's going to be easy and you're going to love it. And I guarantee you're never going to go back, because once you go Linux, you'll be done with Windows. You'll have an older computer. Your older computer will run. It'll run faster. It'll almost be like you have a brand new computer. And another thing, advantage of Linux, is that the updates are fast. When you do the updates in Windows, it takes hours. And the thing's spinning and spinning and spinning. And it says, just wait a moment. You ever seen that? Just wait a moment. Well, in the Windows world, a moment could be like 2 hours. Linux gets updated right away. Might take 5 minutes to do an update, and that's it. Fear not. I'm going to do this video in parts. I'm not going to do a super long video. And as you can see, look at this. You got advertising here. What is this? What is this? Look at this. Oh, I can't stand this. Anyways, I'm going to do this in many, many parts. I'm going to do a lot of short videos. I'm going to take it step by step and show you how to transition from Windows to Linux. So don't go away. Stay tuned. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like it and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Until next time, I am the Linux Mensch.